Thanks for joining us and welcome to Ories News. Today we've got Simon Dunkley with us in the studio. Simon, thanks for joining us, mate.
Thanks, Nick. Yeah, good to be here, as always.
And if we have time later on, we'll open up the lines. You can ask Simon a few questions. Alternatively, you can text your question through. Just type studio, leave a space, and then write your question. Obviously, texts will incur a 50-cent fee, so kids ask your parents first. But before we get to that, we've got our reporter Matt Franklin out in the field with today's match report.
Yeah, look, I'm going to have to call you back. But I think the studio's going to cross to me shortly, but man, it's the last time I'm doing this with these clowns, eh? I mean,
okay, Matt's obviously having some technical difficulties there. Okay, yeah, we're going to take one of your calls now. We've got Gavin on line one. Go ahead, mate.
Yeah, Gavin. Hi, Darren here.
Yeah, you're on the air, mate. Go ahead.
Okay, big fan of the show, guys. Keep up the good work. Just ring up Brian Nyberg. Obviously, he's entering the twilight of his career. You think this is going to be his last season, Nick?
Okay, thanks, mate. Yep, fair point. Actually, Simon, I might throw that to you. Okay. You're in the Ories engine room. You know what's going on there. What's the feel within the team about that?
Look, Nick, Brian's playing fantastically, as he has his whole career, actually. Been privileged to play alongside him for a number of seasons now, and I've learned a lot from him. He's got a lot of knowledge that's, you know, you should look to us.
Well, thanks, Simon. I'll have to cut you off there, mate. I've just got word. Matt's ready to go, so we're going to cross right now to Matt Franklin.
Yes, we're coming to you live on this beautiful sunny fine day after weeks of frustration with the weather. As you may have heard this morning, the terror threat after a bomb was found in the Prince of Wales Stadium changing rooms. The match has been moved to the lovely surrounds of Porirua Park, where we face the old foe, the OVU Pink Ginners. So let's sit back now, get yourself a handle of something cold and enjoy the action. Well, an energetic half of football, 8 plays 5, a slim lead to Ories. Let's get back to the action.
Call it, Boo, call it.
Dominate on 4, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Dominate!
Some people stand in the darkness, afraid to step into the light. Some people need to help somebody when the edge of surrender's inside. Don't you worry.
Yeah. red, but as you can see, it's orange.
Oh boy.
Fantastic match. Swung both ways. Gee, I thought you guys were hanging tough, but when do you thought it slipped away from you?
When we sort of missed a ton of tackles in the second half. Just, there was no midfield defence, and yeah, and you guys really exploited that very well, so you played fantastically.
How about the late change of venue? That didn't put a spanner in the works for you?
I felt cold, that's for sure. But yeah. Full credit, you guys are fantastic.
Well, thanks for being part of such a great match.
Cheers, mate.
With the victorious captain, Boo Birdsall. Boo, you kept your fans a bit tense there. The game went to and fro. When did you think you had it in the bag?
Not until that second to last try, to be honest. It was a tough game. We went up early and then kind of eased off, thought we had it, and then they came back at us. Bit of quick line-outs and fitness and stuff like that, but we managed to come through in the end, but it was a bit hairy.
And you figured probably in one of those tries. Take us through your little twinkle toes down the touchline there.
Well, I have been watching Christian Cullen and how he brings the ball back in counter-attack, and I think it was the Vaseline-coated jersey which helped me get past that second-to-last defender to put Kerry away in the corner.
Oh, well done, Boo. Fantastic victory. We look forward to the rest of the season.
Thank you very much.
We've got our Brute Max man of the match here. We're joined by Imani, who figured prominently through his bustling runs in midfield, also his kicking game was on song. Probably the difference today is they pulled away in the second half. Imani, how did you see your game today?
Well, yeah, I've been training for an hour and a half last week to practice my kicking goal. I aimed for my game today. It was a pretty good result.
You have the ball on a string, a couple of kicks from wide out. Really impressive stuff.
Yeah, it was practices a lot from the corner flag in the middle, because I normally not converting my kicking code in the middle of the field, and then I practiced a lot from the corner flag, so it was great.
Thanks, Imani. Tremendous game, and we look forward to the rest of the season with you. Well, there you have that. He was our man of the match, and I'm getting word now. Yes, we're ready to cross back now live to the studio with Nick.
Thanks, Matt. Well, what an exciting finish to such a great game. And Simon, you did bloody well getting back here so quickly.
Just skipped the post-match warm-down and didn't bother with a shower. Just jumped into a cab and cruised over here to the studio.
Well, thanks for that. But yeah, you really needn't have bothered. We haven't got any text questions come through, and also no one has rung up. Is there anything you want to add? Anything you want to say before we go?
Actually, on a serious note, Nick, I'd just like to say hi to Hank, Nicola and Baby Tian up in Auckland. All the best up there, and hopefully we'll see you back down here soon.
Yes, and of course the Ories News team are thinking of you and send our best wishes, along with the wider Ories rugby community. So thanks for watching, everyone, and we'll catch you later.
Oh, this Ories News outfit. Honestly, I've never seen such a shonky outfit. I'm supposed to be picked up after the match. It looks like I'm going to be walking home.